Here is a case of huge hydronephrosis crossing the midline with thin parenchyma because of the pelvic-uretric junction impacted large stone. These type of kidneys are commonly seen. Open surgery is standardized practice, but in the present era, laparoscopic surgery, robotic surgeries are done. The laparoscopic point of view, making the port is difficult in the initial part. When the kidney is such massively enlarged, going from the liver to the pelvis and crossing the umbilicus. Ultrasound is very useful. Even then, port can touch the kidney and then leak of the urine can occur, which makes the procedure difficult. Emptying of the kidney through the lateral aspect by PCN is standard practice. But in this video, what we wanted to show is, we have dilated up to 22 French. We have not put a Foley's catheter or nephrostomy tube. We kept the amplage sheath like that. We sucked, keeping the amplage in all parts of the kidney. Because if you empty normally with suction, 50% of the kidney gets emptied and rest of the fluid in the kidney makes kidney not able to grasp during nephrectomy. Unless we empty completely the sac, nephrectomy becomes difficult. As such also, very enlarged kidney makes the dissection of the colon, duodenum and the renal vessels easy. But in this case, so much enlargement is present, emptying is necessary, partial emptying is not good. So, amplage sheath is kept in situ during the laparoscopic surgery. When you press the kidney, a little bit amount of fluid in the lower pole, upper pole, pelvis may be there. That can also be sucked so that folding of the tissue of the kidney can be done and proper retraction can be done and the tissue can be released easily so that in no time you will reach the renal vein and artery. That is the main point of sharing this video. This is unedited video of laparoscopic part 38 minutes without any voiceover. That's why this introduction is given. Thank you.